focus and energy into it as I'm creating it. And then that way, when it's finished, it's completely charged and it's ready to use in whatever way that I want to use it. And then to release that sigil, there's so many things that you could do as well. I talked about burning it in a fire, or burning it over a candle, or keeping it under a candle and then burning that candle to let the energy be released through that force. You could also let it fly in the wind. You could let it drop into a river and return to the waters. You could bury it in the earth and let the earth take it. Depending on what you're trying to achieve with that magic, that's how you should release the sigil. You should understand what you're trying to achieve with that magic. If you're going to make a love spell, for instance, you could make a little sachet and put all of your precious stones and herbs in it, and then put your sigil inside of it, and then keep that in a safe place, or carry it with you as you speak to your lover, and then while you're with that person, that energy from the sigil and everything else will be right there with you. Or put it underneath your lover's pillow and it will guarantee that they still have your attention and your desire. If you want to get back at an enemy, you could always put your sigil into a box and then bury it, make it like a funeral and bury it. And in that way, you're burying all of that hatred and anger, and there's a lot of things that you could do with it, a lot of things. But the point is that the way that you create the sigil has a lot to do with what kind of magic you're casting, and the way that you release the sigil has a lot to do with the way that you're casting your magic. So those are two very important elements to think about while you're creating a sigil: how it's created and how it's released. And then while you're creating it, make sure that you have complete focus, complete single-mindedness, so that you know that when you're finished creating that sigil, it's going to be a symbol that carries all of your magic power and all of your desire. And it's directed and focused, and it's contracted and put into a very condensed form, a very symbolic type of magical shorthand. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, please ask them down there in the video comments. Unfortunately, I don't like the way that YouTube set up their whole video viewing and everything else. They keep changing everything around. And every time I come back to YouTube, everything's different every time. I'm still trying to learn how to use YouTube. But anyway, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. And don't forget to visit my Facebook page. I'm going to put a link in the sidebar where you can get to my Facebook page. And don't forget to visit my blog, where I try to post at least twice a month on different topics that are important to Satanists. And if you have any questions relating to this video, please post them in the bottom of the video. I'm going to let all the comments through that are related to the video. If it's a comment that's unrelated to the video, I'm just not going to accept it. I don't have time for it. And if you'd like to get a hold of me, the best way to do that right now is through Facebook, because that's where I'm doing a lot of my networking now, because it's really easy to connect with everybody, and it's really fun to be able to post comments and reply to my fans on Facebook. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope you learned a lot, and don't forget,